Hello everyone, welcome back to Rooting Happiness. So as promised, today's video is about beliefs again. Today I'm going to be talking about how to change some of these core beliefs that we form during our childhood mostly. As I had mentioned yesterday, I think so, that we form most of our core beliefs between the ages of 0 to 7. When our logical mind is not yet developed, so most of the thoughts that we think, we are not able to refute them, we are not able to logically discriminate between whether it is really the truth or whether it is just our perspective. I had also spoken about this in a previous video, where I had spoken about how children are so egocentric in their thinking. And that's basically how we make some of our core beliefs. Now, the process of belief change there are many ways to change a core belief. The first step in changing a core belief is to identify what a core belief is. So how are we going to identify what is our core belief? So let's take a situation that may possibly be a problem situation for you, or a situation that you're not very happy with. It's not turning out the way you wanted it to. So let's say, for example, I am not really getting the promotion that I wanted in my job, or I'm constantly having to leave my job again and again. Either I'm quitting my job again and again, or I'm getting fired from my job. My performance in my job is not that great. And so I'm not really getting what I want from my professional life. It's not fulfilling for me. Now, how do I identify what is the core belief behind this? So when I think about this, when I recollect all my experiences in my professional life so far, I can sit and evaluate about what is it that I really think or feel about these professional experiences. Do I feel that these experiences have made me feel very low in self-esteem? How do I really think about these experiences? I probably could be thinking that, you know, I'm just not able to do my work properly, and then that thought goes into a spiral of, maybe it's me, maybe I don't know how to do my work properly, maybe I'm not fit to work in a corporate or a professional life, you know, maybe I'm just not meant to be successful. And then these thoughts keep spiraling. So how do you identify what is the real main thought behind this? Is when you keep thinking about all of this, and then you keep asking yourself, so what is it that I really think and feel about this situation? And you will finally, after questioning this again and again, you will finally probably come to this conclusion that maybe what I think is that I'm not competent in my work, and so I'm not being able to perform. So I either quit because I am scared of a responsibility, so before somebody can give me that kind of responsibility, I quit, or I'm getting fired because I'm really not competent, you know. So like I spoke about it, it also becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy, where because my beliefs, I keep thinking about them, I keep having these thoughts and these beliefs play out in my life as my own reality, they become a self-fulfilling prophecy. So now, what do we do about this? Now that I've identified this core belief that I am not competent to work or to be successful at my work, I'm not competent enough, what do I do with this belief? So now I have, these are some of the things that I can do. Step number one is go back to some of my previous experiences and try and figure out, how did I get onto this belief? How did I start thinking about the fact that I'm not competent? Was it in my first job? Was it even before that, was it when I was studying or was it in my childhood when somebody told me that, you know, you can't do anything properly. I don't think you will ever be successful at anything you do. So I can go back and trace to probably the earliest that I can remember of when I started thinking like this about my work. That's the first step. The second step is to identify, now what do I want from this? What do I really want? Now that I have established that I probably have this thought that is not allowing me to work, that is not allowing me to perform really well at my job, now what is it that I want? So this is going to be my new belief that I'm going to create now. So the new belief is going to be, let's say for example, that I am capable of performing really well at whatever I do. Okay, let's say that is my new belief, that I'm capable of performing really well at whatever I do. Now, what do I do with this new belief? How do I reprogram my mind to actually start believing this new belief? So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to so there are a couple of techniques. The first technique, and this is one of my most favorite techniques that I also recommend a lot of my clients to do, is look into the mirror. Look into your eyes and tell yourself, take your name and tell yourself, Anushree, you are competent enough to perform really well at your work. Now, keep repeating this. What will happen is, sometimes you may feel resistance towards accepting this new belief because this is not your reality yet. This is not how it's actually happening in your life. So you will think, but wait, that's not true. I am actually goofing up at work. I'm not performing really well. So how can I tell myself that? I'm fooling myself. Well, you could say that this is trying to reprogram your mind into believing something that may not be true yet, but has the potential of becoming true. So you keep telling yourself that, Anushree, you're going to do really well at your work. You are capable and you're competent enough of performing really well at your job. And you keep telling yourself this every day. And even when you're feeling this resistance coming up, you can acknowledge this resistance and say, yes, yes, I know it's not the situation right now, but I know I'm capable of being there. And so I'm going to keep telling myself this so that I can believe it more and more and can become more true to me. That's number one. Number two is you could write down these new beliefs and you could have action plans set for yourself as to how you're going to make this belief come true for yourself. So what is it that you can do for this belief to come true? So let's say for example, you have an action plan ready that for me to be competent enough at my work, I need to A, really improve my focus, B, I need to become a little more confident in my work, C, I need to understand what are my strengths and what are my weaknesses, and then accordingly work. Now this will help me to understand what are the areas that are not allowing me to perform really well and work on those areas that are actually stopping me from performing well and become good in those areas so that I start becoming better in those areas, and then eventually this becomes my new reality that I am competent enough to do whatever I want to do and I'm competent enough of doing good work, right? The third one is for you to be able to tell yourself every day by making sure that you're aware of the conversation you're making with yourself. So this is a very interesting thing where you're being very aware of the conversation that you're making with yourself every day. And you're telling yourself, whenever you feel that this old belief is coming up, right? Whenever you feel that this thought is coming up that, oh no, I'm not good at this, or I can't do this, you know. So your core belief will not come up in this exact statement that you are not competent enough to do good work. It will come up in different ways of everyday thinking, you know, that you're not doing this properly, or this is not working properly, you know, or you can't do it, you know, things like that. So when these negative thoughts about this situation come up, acknowledge them. Tell yourself that yes, they are negative thoughts. I allow them to go. And I am going to think now of the positive thoughts. And then you start thinking about the positive thoughts. Start focusing on the positives of what you're doing. And start acknowledging all the positive aspects of that situation. And that's how you slowly start building on your positive and healthy core beliefs, and it becomes slowly your reality. Now I want you to remember one thing. These core beliefs have most probably been formed when you were somewhere between 0 to 7 years of age, when your logical mind was not working at its best, and you were very susceptible to thinking whatever that anybody is saying is true for you. But now you are at an age where you can think clearly for yourself and you can give yourself proof. So go back to all the things that you have done well in that area, in that aspect, and start giving yourself proof every day that this is what I had done good. So it's not that I'm not competent at all. Maybe I lack somewhere, but it's not true that I'm not competent at all. So I want you to remember this aspect, and I want you to go back and give yourself proof every day of all the things that you have done right. So make a list of all the things that you have done right. Of course, make a list of all the things that have gone wrong as well. But make sure that you also make a list of all the things that you have done right. Even if that list is not as big as the other, make sure that you open that list and read it every day, because that is what you are capable of, right? You are capable of doing good things, you're capable of working, you're capable of doing good work. Maybe it wasn't happening as often as you would like it to happen, but it is happening. It has happened in the past and it can very well happen in the present and the future. So remember that this is who you are, this is what your beliefs are, and you get to decide what you want to believe about yourself. Nobody else needs to make that decision. You don't need to accept anybody else's decision. This is your decision as a mature adult as to what you want to believe in, so that you can achieve the goals that you have decided for yourself. I know this video is a little long, and I really hope that it helps you in achieving the results that you want. This is a very general aspect of changing core beliefs. If you would like to know more specific things or more specific ways in which you want to work on changing your core beliefs, I would request you to please leave a comment in the comment box so that I can get in touch with you and help you and guide you a little bit about this. I also plan to write a blog on this topic because it is such a vast and important topic. So hopefully that will be out soon. Thank you so much for watching this video, and please leave your comments, like and share if this has helped you. Thank you.